welcome to The Social Connection. We are back again with the latest from the virtual world. I'm Urmila Bhattacharya, and with me is my colleague Ishani Mathur.
Starting from the birth of a new state to cabinet ministers taking oaths and the horrific gang rape case, this week saw an overflow of political events. We also saw Gangnam Style breaking yet another YouTube record.
And in our Let's Get Social section, we look at getting some extra security for your precious documents and data. But first, let's take a look at the top trending stories that caught our attention.
FIFA excitement builds up on social media.
YouTube launches a campaign to encourage LGBT athletes.
Now access Facebook without a data connection in your cell phones.
And Turkey lifts ban on YouTube.
With a week to go for the Football World Cup 2014, the excitement is building up. And here's how you can stay up to date on your favorite matches, teams and players using Twitter. Take a look.
Twitter has created official hashtags for the Football World Cup, hashtag World Cup and hashtag Brazil 2014, to provide real-time updates on all the actions for the 64 matches, seeking to tap into the craze around the sporting event, which will begin in Brazil. Through these hashtags, people can join conversations together on Twitter and follow the action closely. The FIFA World Cup 2012 will take place from June 12th to July 13th, with the opening match in Sao Paulo between Brazil and Croatia. Twitter has also introduced a feature called 11 Dream Team, which is made up of the most mentioned player Twitter handles in the past 3 months. The top three mentioned players on Twitter are Neymar, Cristiano Ronaldo and Wayne Rooney. According to Twitter, more than 300 of the players from the 32 competing nations are on Twitter, with representatives of all the competing teams having a presence on the platform. Citing recent global research from Nielsen, Twitter claims that it is the second screen to TV broadcast. It creates a space for live commentary in the moment from fans and experts alike across sports. According to Nielsen, 50% of the tweets about TV in 2013 were related to sports, and 492 million tweets sent in 2013 were about sports events. The Indian landscape is no different, with Twitter becoming the second screen to TV broadcast. A research from Global Web Index shows that 87% of Twitter users in India will be watching the World Cup, and 90% of Indian users will use Twitter for something related to football. The study further revealed that nearly half the 45% of people on Twitter in India follows football clubs. More than half of the football lovers in the country say that the news breaks fastest on Twitter. It also claims that 56% of Indian users tweet when there is a goal and 61% tweet after the match.
Sports brings people together from all backgrounds and experiences through a shared passion. And YouTube shares that spirit of connecting diverse communities to make a difference.
Sport has the power to change the world. It has the power to unite people in a way that little s does.
YouTube launches their 2014 Gay Pride campaign, Proud to Play. They are making sports the singular focus of the company's Gay Pride efforts. The campaign consists of original videos with various LGBT athletes.
I'm dating a guy and I couldn't be happier.
I'm Michael Sam. I'm a football player and I'm gay.
Robbie Rogers now breaking yet another barrier.
From the Sochi Olympics to the recent NFL draft, this year has seen a growing global conversation about the lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender community in the world of sports. Many LGBT athletes are sharing their stories on YouTube, and the support they are getting from teammates and fans has helped others find the courage to do the same. YouTube celebrates LGBT Pride Month and the upcoming World Cup with a new social push called Proud to Play, honoring the athletes, their supporters and the YouTube creators who stand up for diversity.
Because of you, there is a little boy playing basketball right now who knows that he can be who he is and play the sport that he loves.
When you look back on these years, you will see a time in which we put a stop to discrimination against gays and lesbians.
The movement, which features this video created by cobbling together footage from TV, games and online, also asks you to upload your own video showing what Proud to Play means for you. They are also encouraging YouTubers to create videos about LGBT sports issue that YouTube will highlight over the next month.
Não importa quem você ama, O que importa é fazer gol.
Being gay in sports doesn't change the way you play the game.
Sport unites us.
Let's support a world where every athlete can be proud of who they are.
It's important to be proud to play.
Jogue com orgulho.
I'm proud to play.
Jogue com orgulho.
This is the biggest moment in sports. It's our time to make a difference and show the world that every athlete can be proud to play.
The YouTube Pride logo featuring a rainbow soccer ball will be on every YouTube page.
Sport can create hope where once there was only despair.
State-run BSNL has launched a service wherein its mobile consumers will be able to access Facebook without any internet or data connectivity. Take a look.
State-run telecom service provider BSNL launched a service where users can access Facebook on mobile sans internet connectivity. In a statement, the company said users will be charged 4, 10 and 20 rupees for 3 days, weekly and monthly plans respectively for this service. The service runs on unstructured supplementary service data technology, which is typically used by operators to send alerts to users. The public sector telecom firm has tied up with Utopia Mobile to provide Facebook access through USSD in East and South zones immediately. The service will be launched in West and North zones shortly. USSD can also be used for prepaid callback service, location-based content services, and menu-based information services. Users will be able to access their accounts, view or post status messages, respond to friend requests, write on the walls of friends, view birthday reminders and send messages. All the typical functionality Facebook provides users. Moreover, the service will work on all handsets, though it isn't clear whether they will have to support Facebook's mobile app or will be able to access the service through the phone's browser. BSNL Director Anupam Srivastav said that the companies today are looking at enhancing the portfolio of offerings to voice and SMS customers, and they're excited about this new service with the rising popularity of social media. Now, with this new initiative, users in regions where there is lack of internet connectivity can access Facebook.
YouTube is back online in Turkey after more than 2 months in the dark. The move comes after the country's highest court ordered authorities to restore its access. Here's a report on that.
The government of Turkey lifted its ban on YouTube last week after the apex court's decision, which said the ban violates the basic right of freedom of speech. The court in its order cited the Turkish constitution's freedom of expression clause, which guarantees that everyone has the right to express and disseminate his or her thoughts and opinions by speech, in writing, pictures or through other media. Free speech online has been a delicate issue in Turkey amid the recent domestic uprisings, which have relied heavily on social media. Earlier in March, Turkey also blocked access to Twitter due to alleged violation of personal rights and privacy. The ban of Twitter and YouTube came within a month after audio recordings on some social media exposed alleged government corruption. Previously in 2007, YouTube was blocked in Turkey, but that ban was lifted in 2010.
Now it's time for us to take a break. Do stay with us to see how Sai broke yet another YouTube record.
And we'll see what kept the celebrities talking across the globe and the top 5 videos you loved on YouTube.